should be completely done. If it isn't done by now, there is a way to check. If you press your finger in the middle of the crust after you take it out of the oven and it springs back, then it's done, and the sides will be soft, so that's another way to know. Just make sure that when you pressed it into the pan that it was completely pressed, because you can see in one area of the pie that you can see right now in the corner that it's a little bit crooked. And maybe that's okay with you, but it wasn't okay with me, so just be careful of those things and you'll do great. Last night of our lives, we'll keep dancing till we die. I hear your heartbeat to the beat of the drums. Oh, what a shame that you came here with someone. So while you're here in my arms, let's make the most of the night, like we're gonna die young. We're gonna die young. We're gonna die young.
When you start to beat your mixture, you want to definitely beat it on a low speed, because it'll definitely look way better in the bowl than on you. And powdered sugar goes everywhere, trust me, I have so much more experience of that than you might have. I mean, like, maybe you bake more than I do, but the amount of times powdered sugar has gotten on me is, like, older than I am, which is a lot. Not really, but, anyway, just, you want to make sure that you do it low until the powdered sugar starts to disappear, basically, into the peanut butter, and then you can start beating it a little quicker, and then it'll look something like this. You definitely want to scrape down your bowl here. You really don't want to waste this stuff. It is heaven. Basically, if you added more confection / powdered sugar, it would practically be the easiest buttercream in the entire world. You probably have to add more butter, though. I don't know. But seriously, you want to make sure you get all this stuff, because it's really not going to go to waste. Because I actually ended up not having, like, it would fill, it fills it all the way to the top, but it would, I don't know. Just don't waste it. It's really good. Like, I almost just started spreading it on crackers, but then I stopped for myself. Just make sure that your pie crust is, like, actually not hot. Otherwise, some of it will start to melt, and then you have to be really panicky. But after you get all the peanut butter out, which will take some muscle, as you can see, I'm trying to, like, get all of it out, because I want all of it. So you need to use a circular motion inside the bowl. And then once you smooth it out to whatever you think you can get it to, throw it in the freezer, especially if some of it ended up starting to melt. But even if it didn't, you wanted to get it in the freezer anyway, so then it can set. So then you can start in your ganache, and then ganache can set on top of the peanut butter, and then you can freeze it again. After you put the pie / tart in the freezer, the peanut butter should be like this. It'll be like firm to the touch when you touch it, so that's what it should feel like. To make chocolate ganache, you just need a container big enough to hold one cup of heavy cream, because it heats up really quick. You just put the heavy cream in there and place it on medium-low heat, because if it scalds, you have to throw it out, and it's really gross. Anyway, you just need to heat the cream until those, you see bubbles, basically, so it's simmering. Then you need to pour the cream into a smaller bowl, and then you need to pour the chocolate into that bowl, or have chocolate in a bowl and pour the cream over the chocolate. Either way will work. Then stir it just once, and then leave it alone for 5 minutes, then come back and stir and stir and stir, and eventually, once it gets shiny and velvety, it's done. Once it's shiny and velvety and your peanut butter is still set, or still in the freezer, or at least cold enough, you can pour the chocolate over the peanut butter now.